Hi folks, I'm Hector Garcia. I'm an accountant and have a big YouTube channel, in my world anyway, about accounting and QuickBooks and that sort of thing. A lot of people ask me, what kind of microphone do I use or what microphone should they get so they can start doing videos, webinars, web meetings, podcasts, whatever. So I actually own a lot of microphones, right? I have this guy right here, it's a Vifin K669. I have the Sennheiser SC30. I have a lavalier lapel mic, and there's like a million different versions. I don't even know which one this is anymore. I'll figure it out and I'll put it in the description. I also have this microphone here, which is a dynamic range microphone, which is really my weapon of choice. So if you were to ask me, what microphone should I use? You should get a microphone like this. This one's called a Samson Q2U. It's about $60. It's hooked up to a shock absorber, which is probably about $15, and then it's hooked up to a boom mic, which a boom arm, which is between $20 and $100. I have a really good one because I think boom arm should be good. The problem is it takes a lot of space on your desk. Also with this one, if I turn my head away from the microphone, you clearly hear a change in audio, where the other microphones I'm gonna show you don't have that issue. So by far, if you're gonna get a setup with least amount of expenditure as possible, something like this is what I would recommend. And just, you know, make sure that you always speak straight, have the microphone and your mouth at the same distance. But I'm gonna check, I'm gonna test a couple of these with you so you can hear the different options, the different versions of working with different types of microphones. So again, this is the Samson Q2U, and now we're gonna switch to another one. So now I'm working off the lapel mic. So it's this mic over here, sitting on my chest. What's nice about this, if I angle the camera in such a way, I could probably completely disappear the microphone off the frame of the video, right? Depending on how far really I put it from my mouth. But that's could be an option if you're trying to get that type of look. Now these microphones have a little bit of an issue. They don't really pick up the voice is coming directly from your mouth, obviously because they're not sitting in front of your mouth. So if you insert any sort of background noise to the background element to it, it's going to pick it up. So I'm going to give you an example. I have this app called White Noise, which is really good. I use it to go to sleep. I'm going to go ahead and play this background frog. You can hear it. Okay. And I will just emulate this as background noise or maybe noise from outside the house. So I'm just going to leave this on my desk. And I'll continue speaking with that background noise in there. You'll pick up a little bit of it. Maybe it's too much right now. And I want to switch to the different microphones so we can see exactly the effect that these type of microphones could have on background noise, because my room is not sound treated. I don't have any sound isolation. So if I have people screaming in the background, if there's people outside my house making noise, you will pick it up. So it'll be wise for you to decide a microphone, not just on sound quality, but also can it filter out or can it cancel out some of the background noise? So I'm gonna switch to a different type of system, which is gonna be a headset microphone. This is probably gonna be one of the best at removing background noises. This is the Sennheiser SC30. I'll put a description, a link in the description below. Great microphone, we're gonna switch to that, especially so you can sort of combine the quality of my voice and also that background. There's frogs in the background. I'm on the Sennheiser SC30. We still got that background noise in there. So, and this is only really my phone, literally about 2 feet away from the microphone. But this is to illustrate that this type of microphone, even though it could be close to the noise, it's really mostly going to concentrate on the audio coming out of my mouth. And this is really, really good because I can move around and I will never be away from the microphone. So that's kind of one of the big advantages. Now, one of the challenges with this is it's not going to be very full. It's going to filter out a lot of lows. So this is going to be very sort of concentrated on the mids and the highs. So it will have more of a tinny sound. But if you want to isolate background noise, this could be a good option. Now, this microphone is called the Vifin K669B. It's about $30 in Amazon. It's really, really popular. A lot of people have bought it. I've seen a lot of YouTubers use it. It's a good mic. I mean, it's for the most part, it's got really good quality for the price. but it's not a dynamic range microphone, so it will pick up background noise even for anything that's sort of around. And you should hear the frogs in the background. I haven't changed the volume of it, but it allows you to sort of contrast and see the differences. So this is the Fifine K669. It comes with a little stand like this. And what's really interesting is that this is not a dynamic microphone, dynamic range microphone. So if I actually turn my head a little bit, you're actually not going to hear so much variances on the audio. So that's kind of an interesting thing compared to maybe something like this. So I'm going to switch to this guy, even with the background noise, so we can see, we can hear what that sounds like. So we're back on the Samsung Q2U. Again, dynamic range microphone. It's only about a couple of inches away from my mouth, sitting in a boom arm. As long as I record my video without moving my head too much away from it, it's going to be the best choice. And this is also going to be better at filtering out some of the background noise from the frogs that you should be hearing, hopefully a little bit lower than with the other microphones. So what should I get? That's what people tell me. What should I get? And that really does matter. It makes a difference depending on what kind of setup you have. Let me go ahead and turn this thing off. So it does make a difference on the setup that you have. If you the more sound treated your room is, the less background noise that your room has. You can go with a different type of microphone. Even some higher end microphones are only really good for that type of setup. But for a room like mine, which is an untreated room, this is my window, this is outside my house where there's background noise, something like this is going to be the best setup. It's going to be a lot bulkier because it takes space on your desk, you know, and this thing sitting right in front of your face, and you can bump into it by mistake. And I'm sure you heard that. Sorry. So it's got its pros and cons. What I like is that it's sort of hovering. So if I move my mouse, my hands, because I'm moving my mouse or I'm hitting keys, I'm not going to bump into it, which something like this is going to be more likely that I will bump into it while I'm trying to type in. But if you were to ask me, what should I get? What should I get? I would say this guy right here. I'm going to go back to it and wrap it up with this one, and I'll explain to you why I think it's the best choice. So if you can only afford one, this is the best choice for a couple of reasons. One, this guy only has audio on one ear. So if I'm doing a podcast and I'm having a conversation with someone, I can pick up what the person is saying. I can also hear for background noise. So if there's a lot of background noise and I can't pick it up because I'm wearing a headset that kind of covers everything out, I don't know what's going on with the background noise. So I like this because I can hear the person I'm talking to in a Zoom meeting or a podcast, and I can also monitor the audio that's coming around me. Now, the only reason I like this is because this guy can actually be flipped pretty easily, so you can choose which side the microphone is in. It might be something you like or something you don't like. I find that to be just extremely practical. Plus, it has some built-in controls here, so you can lower and increase the volume. Again, if you're having a meeting or a Zoom meeting, you don't have to be looking for the volume button to press or mute. And also has a mute button, so I'm going to press the mute button. So then now when I press on mute, you can hear me again. So little things. And if you travel and you want to have a great microphone to have meetings while you travel, it's USB, hooks up to your laptop. Again, I think that if you're just getting started with recording audio, with podcasts, with webinars, with Facebook Lives or whatever, and you want to have a great, high-quality powerhouse that can do it all for $40, this is the best choice. Hopefully this video was useful. Hopefully you can get whatever it is that you want to get your hands on and get some content created and get your high quality audio in all your meetings. Thanks.